Hey, it's me, Destin. Welcome back to Smarter Every Day. There's a lot of stuff that goes into making this YouTube channel, and some of it's more complicated than others, and there's a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff that you don't see. This is one of those types of things. I wanted to learn some stuff, and I called in an expert, and he happens to be a personality here on YouTube. His name is Linus Sebastian from Linus Tech Tips. So the thing you might not realize about Smarter Every Day is I have a problem. And it's because of this thing right here. So as you know, this is the V2511 high-speed camera. This is the workhorse of how I do slow motion video on the channel. But the problem is you got two types of memory on this camera. You have volatile memory on the camera. Think of it like RAM on your computer. So if you shoot something, you got a certain amount of RAM that can save on this local camera. And if you ever lose power, you're done. There's non-volatile memory on top, and this persists if you lose power, right? So this is 512 gigabytes of memory. But the problem is, after every shoot, I have to do something with this. So I have a problem. Let me show you what I did to try to fix this problem. So about, I don't know, a year ago? No, 6 months ago, I sent this particular, come on over here. About 6 months ago, I sent this tweet out to a guy named Linus Sebastian. He does this thing where he puts, I don't know, servers in people's houses, and I called him here. So Linus, I need your help, buddy. This is pretty serious.
I'm here. All right. Yeah, this is really serious. This is bad.
First, let me show you my hard drives. Can I show you this?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me get the hard drives and show it to you.
I don't know if I can handle this.
I'm sure you've seen people with more than this, right?
No, I think this is more than even Justine had.
Okay. So this is not all of it. There's more. Do you mean to stick with this?
No, I want to see. Bring on the carnage.
Okay. Let me go get the old stuff.
So let's start doing some inventory here, I guess. 434 gig. So we're at 2.5 terabytes. That's a 1 terabyte, 3.5.
So this is the old stuff. I call this the deep vault.
5.5. This is an 8 terabyte drive.
Yeah, it is.
And it's literally duct taped to two other drives.
That's how I roll, man. It's pretty serious. And so I literally go to the spreadsheet. Look at this. So I have an entire spreadsheet.
Go have a look at this.
So what I do is I just come in here, I control F, and I'll say like Mars Rover. And so like if I go to hard drive A27, so go find A27. this is how it works, man.
Oh, God.
So A26, 21. Okay, so somebody's moved A27.
So we're finding a flaw in the system already.
We're hosed. We're looking for A27. So A27 is not where it's supposed to be. So you see my problem, right? So these aren't even indexed yet.
We all see your problem.
These are...
Ah, you just dropped it.
Yeah, I did. It was on carpet, so we're good. So it's my understanding you shipped a 45 drive server here.
Yeah.
And we're going to install it, and it's going to make this problem go away.
It might not be enough.
Seriously?
Have you added up the capacity of this?
I have not, no.
Because I'm at like 25 terabytes here already.
Yeah.
I shipped you a 160 terabyte server. So here's the thing. You could make the argument that our data hoarding really doesn't make a ton of sense because we could just grab the necessary footage from a YouTube upload, splice it into our new video when we want to refer back to it, and bippity boppity off to the races. Now with Destin, his case was a really interesting one for me because he actually does not have the luxury of being able to go back to the previous video and grab it without making any very significant compromises. Because this kind of high-speed footage, the data rates are so incredible, and the amount of runtime for what could be a very, very short clip wouldn't make sense to upload in the YouTube video at all. So he's got to pick and choose his battles. So he's throwing out a ton of frames whenever he's showing you, you know, whether it's a hummingbird's wings in real time. He's throwing out a ton of the data in the actual video that you guys watch, except for the small segments that he decides to show you. So everything else here could be necessary if he ever wanted to go back and look at something in more detail. So we gotta get this server rolled out.
You're genuinely worried, aren't you?
Yeah!
My tweet said you would fix my problem, dude.
Wait,
help me, Linus Tech, you're my only hope.
Your tweet says I'll fix the problem, so now it's my liability if it doesn't. Is that right? So you put words in my mouth.
You never actually replied to this.
No, I didn't.
You don't even care. You don't even watch Smarter Every Day. Let's just fix my problem. I don't care.
All right. So let's come over here. So Destin was...
installed it.
Yeah.
Any more light? Oh, it's
the nice yellow light.
Oh, God. He's tripped over the drive.
Sorry.
It was only like 20 terabytes or whatever.
So this is great. We actually had this server shipped down here. It must have been like...
It's a while back.
2 months ago or something like that. It took me a long time to get down here. I'm sorry, because clearly the problem is I would have gotten on the next plane.
It's a big deal,
if I'd known it was this bad.
Yeah.
Now, have you installed the drives in here yet?
No, I have them.
And that's why this drill is here.
Yeah,
we're so we can actually undo the mount.
Yep.
Got it.
Yep. Cool.
Oh, look at that. Oh.
Yep.
I love this video so far.
Are you being sarcastic?
The shenanigans are real. No, I love it. This is great. So Seagate actually shipped you 12 terabyte instead of 10 terabyte drives, which is what I thought they had sent you.
Okay.
So that's another 30 terabytes of raw capacity.
You just rip them open like that?
Which is good. Yeah, yeah, you just kind of shuck them.
Like corn?
Yeah, basically.
I think you think I'm joking, but I actually don't know all this stuff.
So this is just a friction mount here on the side.
It's a spring.
Give it a little more pressure than you're comfortable with. There you go.
That's it?
That's all there is to it.
So this is easy.
This is easy. So the way that RAID works is it's writing the true data, and it's also writing what are known as parity bits. So if I had, let's focus on these four drives right here. I'm running this in, let's say, a RAID 5.
Okay.
That means that for every three pieces of real data, and this is an oversimplification for the sake of it being easier to understand, I'm writing a parity bit that is, think of it kind of like an algebraic expression where this parity bit is the on the other side of the equal sign of these three.
Got it.
So if I were to lose any one of these four things, I can rebuild the other one.
By resolving the equation.
It's a way of rebuilding what you had lost, right?
Right.
But we are not running parity in a conventional sense here. So we're using a software called unRAID that, rather than striping the parity bits so that they exist across multiple drives, it actually uses an entire single drive, or two drives if you prefer to be able to lose two drives, to write all of the parity bits too. So that comes with some advantages and disadvantages. The disadvantage is that it's meant mostly for archival storage. It's not as fast to write to.
Okay.
But the advantage is that in the event that you set it up with a single parity drive and you lose three drives.
Yeah.
Let's say your house floods or something, and it floods up to here. All this data is still good.
Okay.
Whereas if you had the parity bits striped, if you lose more than your threshold, all the data is gone.
I see. So let's say, just for sake of easy numbers, let's say there were 100 terabytes here, mm-hmm. which is more than that, but let's say there were 100 terabytes worth of hard drive space. That's not how much server space I'm going to have.
No.
How much will I have?
You would have anywhere from 80 to 90, depending on what you prefer.
And so that other part is just for the parity bits?
That's right.
This is a big deal for me, man. I mean...
No, it's great. You need it more than anyone else we've deployed one of these to so far, I think.
Are you serious? Yeah. It feels like it.
This is a dire situation.
This is another video for you, but this is like a really significant...
No.
I'm not going to say emotional, but there's a lot of stress tied up in this. Like, a lot of life has been protecting this.
Yeah.
And I've got some in like a safety deposit box. How long is it going to take to slurp all the data?
A long time.
Really?
You've got a big, big data hoarder problem here.
This isn't data hoarding.
There it is. Woo!
Did it work?
Oh, yeah. We can do this later, but I just wanted to make sure all the drives are showing up. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Perfect!
Is it good?
And the SSDs are here too. Yeah,
is it good enough to high five? Okay,
all right.
Just making sure. They're all formatting. Whoa. You can hear them all clicking.
Yeah, they're going.
This is nothing. You do this all the time. You don't care about this at all.
Oh, no, I think it's cool. I think it's cool. I'm sharing your cool experience. So once we set up our array here, even in the event that we actually did lose more than two drives, because it's on RAID, the only data you lose is the data on the drive that physically failed. So that's cool. And then in addition to that, because we're using Iron Wolf Pro drives, they come with a 5-year warranty and they come with a data recovery warranty.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Oh, you're very welcome.
This is a big deal. This is Linus from Linus Tech Tips. They do great videos. They hooked me up here. This is a big deal. Thank you for that.
My pleasure.
And your partners were 45 Drives and Seagate.
And unRAID.
And unRAID.
Yep.
So thank you to you three companies that did that. Really appreciate it. Go subscribe to Linus. Linus does a bunch of
like everything, right? Everything from reviewing keyboards to
pretty much.
You do everything.
To touring the, you know, world's only commercial quantum computer manufacturing facility.
Really?
Yeah, we did that.
Go check stuff out. It's amazing. I like your channel.
Thank you.
Yeah, I've watched your channel for a long time.
Big thanks to Linus for coming out to Alabama. This was a huge problem I had, this data storage issue. Thanks to Linus for working with these companies, his contacts, not mine. You had 45 Drives, who made the enclosure in the server, Seagate, who donated the hard drives, and unRAID, who's running the software on that server. I'm very thankful, and I'm also interested in seeing how he does in the next video. I'm gonna do something kind of interesting. I'm gonna pluck Linus out of his RGB keyboard, gamer system, sandals over socks kind of world, and I'm gonna introduce him to this man.
I'm Luke Talley, and at this time in 1969, I was a senior associate engineer at IBM in Huntsville.
Luke Talley is an amazing individual, and I want to just juxtapose Linus, who's up on all the new tech, with Luke, who had to like figure out how to make memory for computers. I want to put those two together and just see what happens. And it is fascinating. I hope this video that you just watched earned your subscription here to Smarter Every Day. But more importantly, I hope you will stick around and subscribe and ring the bell so that you can see that next video, because Linus and Luke both teaching me really interesting things about one of the most important computers ever built by human hands is a fascinating trip. We went to the US Space and Rocket Center. All that's in the next video. So please consider subscribing if you're into that sort of thing. If not, that's no big deal. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this. I'm Destin. You're getting smarter every day. Have a good one. Thanks, Linus. Bye.
Let me show you a trick. This is a trick I learned about computers.
Yeah.
So like, I have a pen and paper, and sometimes I write things down.
No, I remember the IP. This is a better way.
Okay.